Alright, we should be back, and this time with sound, based on what I see in OBS. Well, streaming is apparently a learning curve as well, larger than I would hope. I'm just wondering whether you're back on the web as well, but it seems that we are. Cool. I'll send myself a heart. All right, so right, I've been trying to remove all containers. I do wonder how containers could be running, but I think that also an easy way to fix that would be to restart the daemon. Because if there are some rock containers, that would also explain things. Well, okay. First stop works. Okay, so let's try to redo test. Connection refused. Cute. If we would do run server, is it the same? No, now it actually works for run server. So the only issue we have is the test environment. So this works. That's the first good sign. So what have you actually changed? Rename the database that was named differently for whatever reason, and we have added a new translation. So let's commit the local file. I mean, it's always good to work in small increments. So synchronize MySQL database with local defaults. And before I do that, let me actually verify that we are not overriding it, because we're using the extended name here. Whereas in the example, this is lagging as fuck. Yeah. So this should be synchronized with example. Actually, let's push it and see. Let's push it and see whether we are still able to have clean CI results. But nevertheless, it's working for run server, so would it work for, would the migration work now? No. Unable to create the table for migrations. That sounds meta, and sounds like something that doesn't have to do anything with what I'm doing. So let's see if Google tells us anything. I mean Google, internet. Also meanwhile, let's see our CI of choice. Do I have a link here? I don't. I should. Huh. I do know that I'm publishing the results onto our Slack, but I'm not on Slack because You know, I would get notifications from our Slacks, and it helps focus. So let's log in and see what we have. This asks for one more tea. I mean, in the expectation that this will be quick, I only put in a bit of tea leaves. You know, I'm always an optimist by heart. Alright, so it seems that we haven't broke the CI by running a build, single build after a year. That's good news. Do we actually have the test summary here? Yep, the few tests we have run, so that's cool. How do they create an initial database? Using a secret script. Oh well. Never mind. So Django migration on our server. So one set trick, Google actually searches more of the internet. Okay, looks like we're not only alone. And looks like you're also only not looking on our questions, so cool. My skill version does not match. Fuck. Well, if it really is unsynchronized version, I don't like where this is going then. Why should I register to view a search results? Can I just view it anonymously and see what happens? Internet in the 21st century. Is it the same? Parameter doesn't seem which table. Yes, it does. The Django migrations, cool. F the same model. Same MySQL passwords. go to the door and see if it's by 5.5 plus. I see. Daytime fields. I totally do have those. Resolves to rate 10.6, which is not supported. 5.5. But we should have 5.5, right? Yeah. We are in jungle version 215. Wait. We have set 2.0. One supports 5.6. So where is that in the end? Well, fuck. Why is this happening? Because you're supposed to be below 2.1. Bounding code, and we have Docker file that reinstalls Docker file. So what's happening here? So let's build web to see whether we don't have just some outdated installation. Yep, 2.13. So this shouldn't happen on fresh install. Proper legacy. Version 10 versus version 20. I guess someone switched to continuous delivery. Okay, so let's try to migrate again. Magic. Except for the fact that we apparently fucked one of the migrations. Excuse me, I'll just make this larger because otherwise... Okay, so this doesn't really tell us which migration fucked it up. Sorry, I'm here. Okay, sorry, let's speed it up. So it's migration, you can see it here. I think applying migration 004. This has a prerequisite that is not satisfied. So let's look it up. So DDCZ, which is the core app, migrations. Migrations. User profile. to learn a shortcut first. So better balance assure at field user profile. Name user, 1-to-1 field, Django model isolation cascade to out users model. I don't really see what's happening here. I mean, I see what's happening. I don't see why it's wrong. We are looking at the correct migration. The dependency should be done. There is a single query. Let's see. Out user model. And have we set it for something else than default or not? I think we may have. So no. Because uzavatela stands for user, and that's where the legacy users are. But it is there only basically for the purpose of migration. I have created this custom auth backend where it basically first tries to authenticate against normal Django user table, and if it fails, then it connects to the legacy table, authenticates the user, and migrates the authentication data with a stronger auth to a new table. But I don't see how that's relevant there, which means I'm missing something, of course. Also, as far as I know, swappable dependency that should be our dependency, and this is a relation between user profile and the user. So I mean, shotgun programming. What is the value of this here? Always use hooks and kisses in programming. So this is a really small screen. I think that we will going to be better off if I will just put it large and be switching windows. So migrate, where were we? I'm in screen, so this is why this is happening. I have a feeling someone's not allowing us to print. So let's do the Python hack way, which is we can write to standard error, and that's usually not buffered or overridden anywhere, and we can flush it. Of course, better to have a debugging environment where you don't need this, but so here it is. and it's output user, which is what I thought. That's correct. This has nothing to do with our custom table. Also, can I bug this to less? Yes, I can. But it is more readable. But that's because we are only piping to less the standard output, not the standard error. And what you can do, this is a pretty neat trick actually. So pipe redirects standard inputs into a command that follows it. If you would use arrow, this would redirect the output to the file called out, standard output. But this way you can redirect the standard error. We don't want to redirect it to a file, we want to redirect it to the standard output. So like merge standard error and standard output, which you can do using this syntax. And then we can redirect it to standard output. At least that's what I remember from the good old days. Right, so strict mode is not set. That's fine. And there is XOXO and there is s01e00. So this works, well, it doesn't work well. It works as we would hope. Why does it insist on relation to the user? Also, shouldn't the table be there from, yeah. So we actually do have a model with a legacy table, but it's not there. All right, and I will tell you why. This is another neat hack. So I wanted to have a way to test against the new version, against the production database, because we are going to the architecture later. But basically, I wanted to create this NAP in a way that it can run against the same database as the old app, so they can run next to each other, because I don't want to commit to a timeline or to a big bang, so things can happen gradually. And in order to be able to do that, and to be able to run migrations on top of a production database, there is this setting called database is seeded, meaning if it's set to true, we are running against a database that was created from a database backup, and then this table was not created by Django, so do not treat it as handled by Django. And I think that this is what's confusing. In case this is not synchronized, this is what's confusing Django. So since we are creating everything this way, let's check what we do have here. And yeah, I have been apparently a year ago working with the production database, so let's overrule it. And it works on circle, because on circle testing is true. So wait, so database is considered seeded? That doesn't sound right. Here we go with make a good naming, because now it sounds like, well, oh yes, if not testing. So if you are not on circle, I have seeded the database, but that's not true now, because we're running against a fresh container. So database is not seeded, and I'm editing in a local ignored file. Let's try again. Right, but everything has buts. This is interesting. So this makes sense, in that once a migration has been applied, then Django doesn't try to rerun it. That's the gotcha. So for the first three migrations has been applied, so changing a setting that has been in those migrations doesn't change anything. What is interesting, though, is that the containers in Docker, they are temporary. Unless you select a volume, like nothing is preserved on disk. And I thought that I haven't, so I'm now kind of confused. Why is it happening that the database is preserved? And also, let me disable Flux, otherwise you will have a yellow screen. It's me, it's not you. So, I mean, it makes sense to have database with a preserved volume, but also interesting. So, if we remove containers, that's the easy way, because the Mongo container should not be running, right? TM. And if it is, then we will be not nice to it. Then we should start creating stuff from day one. The first one was, this is actually a common problem. If you're creating a new MySQL container, then it takes a while for it to create the system tables. And if your Docker is not set up the correct way, then the application tries to connect to that container in that few seconds that Django is trying, MySQL is creating those tables, so you need to add a sleep somewhere or do better retries. But anyhow, this worked. So if we go up and running, there we are. So if we go to connect to our Linux computer, then we should totally be good, except there is this security concept for Django, there is this concept of authorized allowed host, which is usually only localhost, so that when you're developing, random people are not accessing your precious data. So let's do that. Will it auto-reload? One way to find out. Let's refresh first whether I've missed that. I did. Here we are. So this is the initial setup of the new version. If it looks significantly different than this one, that is because one of the supported features is skins, which is actually going to be fun to implement. But if you look at this, we see that we kind of have some initial setup. It looks differently because different CSS and different considerations. We'll come to that. But otherwise, we're ready to go to actually go in a week with the first episode. So I hope that this somehow was useful and will be even more useful. If you want to contribute to this project or just, you know, want to play with it as I follow, it's publicly available on GitHub. As you saw the common pitfalls. I have debugged you, but with the default settings and all links, this should actually work for you pretty well. And here on github.com/GitHub is the address that you should go to. And I'll join you for a team in a week. See ya.